Okay folks, today I'm going to show you how to render these glasses and some kind of liquid inside, and also the steam inside Arnold render, and also this kind of caustic, refractive caustic material, this kind of thing inside Arnold render. This is not a very good lighting, and I'm sure this lighting is not going to win me an award, but for the sake of showing you how to render caustic and nano, I will show everything from the start. So I will delete all the material in there. Okay, so you see inside my harvest, there is nothing. And if you look, all I have is let's go to let's turn it off. Okay. Now let's apply just a Lambert material for everything first, so it's easier to look. Okay, and the sky dome line, I delete it. So now you will see what I have is this kind of corkscrew. Okay, and let me turn off this. Let me delete that. Okay, okay, just in case I hide that, because it's going to take a long time. Okay, delete it. And then I have a bottle, and then a water or liquid. This liquid is just a duplication from this bottle, but the way I model it is I make it a little bit thicker into the bottle, and it seems that this bottle doesn't have any thickness. In fact, it does. See, this bottle has kind of good thickness in there, but it is not that much. However, when I model this bottle, you see in here, it's clearly. I want the water to penetrate the bottle surface a little bit, so it's mean that if I would scale this down a bit, yeah. So I have to make sure that the liquid is in between the bottle surface. This is the outer surface, this is the inner surface. So yeah, also make sure that the liquid touch the bottom of the bottle as well. Okay, and also something wrong here, we can adjust it a little bit. Nice, scaling it out a little bit more. Yeah, it's like we are cheating. Yes, of course. Maybe more, a bit more. Okay, pull down. Yep, I think that's good enough. Now let's get started. I'm going to show you the Arnold material first, and then I will also show you how to use another new material, which is called a JF-Nested Dielectric Material. If you are using Windows, you can download the zip file, and then here is the installation. Let me turn off this Facebook stuff. Here is the how to install it. If you come down to this website, where so you have each plugin and each part goes to each place on Windows. But if you are using Linux and Mac, there is a command from Git, and then you can just run that in the terminal. Okay, now let's get started thing up with the Arnold material. So I will show you how to do a steam. This is the steam of the bottle, I believe. Oh, this is the glass. Let me delete that, and then I will model the steam. Wait a second, I will put all of this, including, okay, the logo, I don't need it. I will put this bottle right in the middle. Okay, and then I will create a cube. This cube, I will smooth it. I will make it to look like a steam or water drop or whatever. Yeah, something like that. Okay, lift it up. smooth it a bit. Okay, get it in the cube, bring it here, and smooth it. This time you can make it elongate, just a little bit elongate, and give it some kind of like irregular pattern to make it like the kind of long stretch of steam. Sorry, English is my second language, so I hope you will bear with me. Okay, make it a little bit flat. Yeah, this one I can duplicate it and then move it to this side. Maybe it would be something. Yeah, make it irregular. And then you can go to polygon mesh. I think it's in mesh tool. Average vertex. I don't know where they have changed that. Okay, whatever. Just smooth this instead. Okay. Now all you need to do is to name this. I call it steam 01. This one is steam 02. This one is steam 03. So bring all the three. Bring all the three to the middle here. Okay, free transform, center pivots. If you want the steams to be on the, let me scale that a little bit, that's too big. If you want it to be attached to the surface of the bottle, you need to install my bonus tool. And in my bonus tool, you see it here, go to modify, go to paint geometry tool. The first thing you need to do is to select the bottle, go to bonus tool, modify, paint geometry tool. And in here, I will type in steam 01, which is the name of the steam here that we are going to paint on. And now all we have to do is to paint. You see, the grid sign tell you how many object is going to be presented in that. So if I increase this, that means the density of this will be more and more. You see, it's getting more and more. If I put it on the scale, so it will give me a random, you can give a jittery value so that your object will be jittery. Okay, I place its quite light around, and then you just change it to steam 2. It will paint with steam 2. I don't know how you call that in English, but I call it steam. Or some kind of ice steam when it's dry. No, and then 3. I think I don't make it too much because it will slow down my computer. So just enough. And so we'll combine all of them. It's easy for me. Okay, that is it. If you look right. And if you try to move the bottle, it will move along. So you don't need these three, delete them all. All of this will come into a new, like this. I would prefer, let me save that first just in case. And then I would combine them into one mesh. I delete the history. I call this steam. The reason is because if you are using Arnold shader, you will need to turn the opaque off. So I want it to be a single mesh, so it's easy for me to just click and that's it. So now let's start go to nut and bolt of how to set this thing up. So the first thing that I have to do is I create a polygon plan, which is going to be used as a light. Let's delete that. This is a background, nothing too fancy. I would call that ground. Let's go to the harbor seat. It's an old form, so in Arnold I go to AI standard, I would call this AI ground. Okay, I select it, apply, and it's there. I don't do anything fancy with it at all. It just like get a full material. Let me turn to number 6. Number 7 is light. Also, you have to realize that I'm using my 2015 or Maya 15. The default viewport is viewport 2.0. It worked perfectly well with Lambert or with Maya Software and Monterey, but not with Arnold at all. In V-Ray as well, I believe. So that is ground. And the next thing that I will have to do is to create another one, which is, I call it AI car crew. Okay, I would apply that to this car crew, and then in the diffuse panel, in the color, I will go to the checkerboard file. I would choose the texture, CG texture, woods. I would use some kind of like maybe plywood. I don't know, plywood or plywood. I don't know. Yeah, this one looked perfectly fine, just like the car crew, some kind of plywood. Yeah, now it's coming up. And my trick is I arrange all of this. Since I put that onto, usually the weight of 7 is not so good, so I would go to 8, and then I would drag this onto the roughness because it's kind of rough as well. And a little bit of spatula, I would drag it onto the spatula, give it a little bit of spec, a little bit only. And for sure the bump map, drag and drop it, and I would choose some kind of like 0.2 just in case. Okay, you can also, now let's start the lighting and do a render test. I have this camera set up right here. So for the lighting, I would create a polygon plan. I make it polygon plan will be used as a light emitter, so the larger the object, the brighter the light will be. So I will make it small first. I don't need many subdivision, maybe just one is enough. Okay, or if you are not sure, you can go to 2, move it up. I look at the camera that way. So since the camera is moving that way, I want it to be this way. Okay, I delete the history. I would check my camera. I would come here. I think 1K is too much. I would drop it low to 340. And then I will have to make sure everything come back to the default in Arnold. So this one is, I put it to 1. This one as well, put it back to 2. Right, everything is going back to normal. So now let's save the scene. Go to hyperset. I would split this into this one, into perspective. Right, so this is my hyperset. I would delete it. For this object, I would give it an AI standard material. Okay, I call it AI light geo. Since it is a geometry which has been used as light, I select it, middle mouse drag and drop it. And then I don't care about anything, I just turn everything off. So it's easy for you to understand. And then I go down to emission. I would make it starting with 5. Okay, you see it looks so bright. I move this away. And then we can come to the IPR. Oh, also we have to make sure that right click here in color management, I change it to linear. Because in Arnold setting, in order for the color to be correctly represented to your eye, you need to make sure that your texture here, gamma correction, set the display to linear because the computer is a linear one, and the texture that come in with a gamma of 2.2, change it to 1. Just change it that way and the color will look correctly. For now, I don't want to mess with anything yet around this yet. I will show you straightforward. And we will do a render test. See, I do the IPR. I will do this bit. And I will take my camera in a little bit just to see how things go. And then I would increase the ease 2, 3 just to see how everything is going. Yeah, that looks not bad. That's cool. You can also increase this to 10 if you wish, but 10 might look good. But since we are planning to use a HDR light as well, so I leave it at 10 first. Also, since I'm using just one texture map for that one, I would go to Arnold TX Manager, select all. I would first let me delete this one. I don't know. Okay, select all, create TX. So our file here. Let me come back here. This is our file which has already been converted to TX, so I would choose TX instead. It's the render file. Okay. If I click render, it's the render file but faster. See that it's rendering fine. Let me try to cut all of this down. I use existing TX texture only. Okay, let's see how fast it goes. Okay, quite fast, so that's the way to do it, easy. In here, also in the system, a lot of people would drop it to 32, since 32 give a lot of fast feedback. I would not recommend that. 64 is the default, which is pretty good. Also, if you have tons of memory, increase that would be very fine. Okay, now let comes to the glass material. Everything is okay. Let's create an AI standard for the glass, especially this bottle. I would call this AI bottle. Okay, I need to make sure that in Arnold I turn the opaque off since it is a glass, and then I right click, apply it to our material. Let's do an IPR about this to see how things work. Okay, and we just do a section around here, double click that, go to our diffuse, turn the weight off. Let me do a little bit, turn the weight off. In the specular section, turn the weight up to 1, maybe this one a little bit down, drop the roughness, turn the Fresnel effect on. In the reflection, I don't want this internal reflection, it's very slow. And then in the refraction, I would turn the weight up. And then for the glass, we need to make it 1.5. Also in the funnel, I would tick that. Let me refresh the rendering. You see it doesn't see through to the other side. The reason is because in here, the glass has a thickness of 4. This one is 2, this one is 2. So just like in mental ray, Arnold will do the same, but you will have to come to the ray depth here, the ray depth section. Actually this is one only from the beginning. So 2 thing doesn't go through, but let me increase that to 3. Okay, let me increase that to 4. Now you see, since it is 4 layer from this side and this side, it's moving up. Okay, and you will see all the droplet here and there. It's cool. If you want to change the colors of the bottle, you see the transmission here, you just choose any color you want, it will change to that. For the bottle, we can use this kind of like strange color depending on you. But mostly it tends to be this. If you want it to be a bottle perfume or whatever, use these colors instead. Right, it looks like a light bulb. I would go to this color, or maybe a little bit green. Yeah, you see it looks so thin and fragile. If you want the bottle a little bit rough, you can go to the roughness, so that it will be a little bit blurry. Okay, if you want it that way, you see, super blurry. Turn it off. Yeah, I would change the color to this. Make that this. I would go to 0.2 to make it a bit blurry. Okay, also specular as well. It looks so soft. You can turn the roughness of the specula up a little bit. So if you turn that up, it's not going to be glass anymore. Anyway, that's fine. I would increase this to number 6. Okay. And to get the line a little bit brighter, I would go to bound fly of 2, reflection of 2, and this one of 2. Usually, my default stuff, I set everything to 2. And if the glass is not see-through anything, I would increase this. For this one, some people would turn it up or whatever. Leave it to 15. Don't care about it. Just focus on this one. Now the glass is ready. Let's create a liquid inside. I call this AI liquor. Maybe just water. Okay, that's it. And for that, I will select the same thing. Make sure that the opaque here is turned off, and we apply it. You see. Then we have to go up as usual, turn the weight of the diffuse off, turn the weight of the spectra on, drop the roughness, go to the funnel, and let me refresh that just in case. And then we come to the reflection, turn that off. For the refraction, turn the weight up to 1. For the water, we need to make it 133. Nice. I would turn this on. Also, yeah. And then for the liquid inside, I would choose some kind of like red wine. Okay. Or maybe some kind of like oranges or whatever. Let's go for red. Okay. Yeah, red is cool. See, now I will duplicate just this one. I would call it AI steam, seeing it is the same. So I would go for the steam. I select all the steam here, apply, but I'm not going to give it some kind of red, give it some kind of like that, which is white. Okay, now it seems that things are looking pretty cool so far. Let us create a caustic material. I save that. So you see it doesn't have any caustic at all. If you want everything to have the caustic, the first one is to go to the AI bottle. In here, you go down to where is it, caustic here, just enable refractive caustic. Based on the documentation of Arnold, refractive caustic seem to consume a lot of sample here, so you want to see it, you need to increase it up so high. So now I turn everything on. I turn the ground, no, turn the light geo, no, turn the steam also. Also the water as well. You see now we start to see some kind of bleeding, which is super cool. That's what I love. If you want to have like an about reflective caustic, glossy caustic, just turn them all on. Right, if you really want to see how things are bleeding. Steam as well. Wow, cool. my machine is going to hang up now. Okay, turn everything on, but let me save just in case. It's saving now. Okay, you see the caustic right there? It's super cool. So now let me mess around with this light. I don't want it to be too bright. I would go to light geo here in the emission tab. I would drop it down to just 5. Okay, and then I would create an anode light, sky dome light. In the sky dome light, I would click the color, wait for it to load up. In anode, I would choose AI image, and then I would click on this. I would go to texture, HDRI. This is the HDRI that I download from SIBL. So let's go with the Z highway of which one is good? Environment, I think environment. No, I might go with the, let's go with this one. Yeah, 3K HDR. Okay, it's causing stuff not to go up. So I think maybe this one, that one is too big. That's why it isn't so up here. Let me refresh that. Wow. Okay, let me render it. If it doesn't render, that's mean it has some problem. Okay, because I set this to render with just the TX file. So I will need to turn sync back on. Okay, and then this time it can render for sure. Oops. Okay, so now I come back. Haha, window. I hate it so much. Okay, it always crashed for no reason. So we come here to check everything, the diffuse. Okay, drop this to 5. And we have to make sure that our bottle has already have the caustic turn on or not. Yeah, we turn everything on. Okay, saved it, and then we create a nano light, sky dome light. Go to anode image, select that. I would go with this HDR, which is quite low. Tropical beach. You can download it from SIBL node. Okay, and I will have to make sure that in my textures, gamma correction texture, I turn everything on. Okay. And then cameras, if you come back here and render, I'm pretty sure it will be very strong, but it's okay. I can select the light. I turn this to 0.1. Go to IPR. 0.1 looks good to me. Maybe you can increase this to 0.3, a little bit brighter, and the sample up to maybe 3, just to smooth everything. The cool thing is we have this kind of caustic stuff around, see, and also the sub here, okay, which is nice. Okay, now let me go for the final render to make it a little bit smooth. I would increase this to 6, as written in the documentation of Arnold. If you want it to be smooth, you need to, okay, we don't mess with all this red up anymore, it seems to be fine. We need to increase the diffuse sample up high, and I would increase this to 2, the diffuse sample up to 6, and I would make this up to at least 5, just to smooth thing out. You see the sample map up to 900 stuff. So I would save it, and then I would pause the video and come back to you. You see thing look pretty smooth and clean here. A little bit of noise here if you need to increase it up, but the cool thing is that we have a caustic here. So Apart from using this one as a line meter, you can also use another line you like called photometric light. Photometric light is nothing but just a visualize. If you want that file, you can go to Google IES light download. You see there's a tons of link that you can download it from. This is an IES light, so each light is kind of generates together to form that. So it's like some kind of like a studio lighting here if you click on that. So I have downloaded tons of it, so I would use just one light. Photometric file, I can go to textures. This is an IES light, decorative one, and then it shows you here. If it doesn't show any light, you can increase it up to like 10 or maybe 15. Sample up, normalize it, sample up like 2. Okay, I would go to 10. For the sake of speed, I would drop this to just 2. The about one is also 2. Okay, and then the tries to let me make sure that I have already said that just in case. Okay, and do another render with the photometric light. You see it looks cool, and the caustic seem to disperse, seem to scatter around nicely around here. Wow, this one looks cool, you see? Absolutely cool. You can also do an IPR and then increase this amount to like 13. Ooh, that's too much. Maybe 11. Okay, I would go to kinda 8. Because I would do one trick with it. Stop the IPR. I would move this a bit. Rotate it towards the bottle, and then I would group it. I would control D to group, turn this to 45 degree, and then shift D, yep, to make sync that way. And let's do an IPR render. It may be burning out, but I'm pretty sure it's fine. See, the bottle is coming out nicely using the same IES light or photometric light. Okay, the reason is because we just want to have a lot of caustic. Okay, please bear with that. Now we have all this kind of bleeding. You see the red bleeding outside here, which is super cool. Okay, and also these caustic around here. Nice. It looks great. Let me undo everything and then I will show you another one. I turn this up to 11, just like before. I will duplicate this bottle. Control D. I will show you another material which has been the talk of town now in our render setting, called nested JF-Nested Dielectric Material, which you can also download from this, as I said, download from this website, github.com, download zip if you are using Windows. If you are using Mac or Linux, that easy, just install this in terminal, that's it. And this is how to set everything up in Windows. This shader is easy to use and quite fast as well, but the caustic, is not kinda good yet, it isn't soft just like this one yet. So to show this correctly, I would put this one I have not grouped yet, so group them. Let me move. Okay, group them. I put them here, and I will not use, okay, let me use that one. Now for this bottle, this is the same but in anode. I will use a new shader called JF-Nested Dielectric Material. I will go to camera 2, pull them over. I will do an IPR. I will render this first. Okay, I will drop thing low and then do an IPR. I will do an IPR for this one only. I would select this photo, apply this material to it. Okay. JS dielectric material, ladies and gentlemen. You see? It kinda look good. If I double click it, I would call that JF bottle. In this basic material, based on the documentation, 0 that's mean glass, 1 is ice, 2 is water. So I would go to 0. Okay, refresh the IPR. Since it is glass, so the IR is supposed to be 1.5 or maybe 4 if you wish. Okay, the transmission scale, will tell you how thick, how clear, and how blurry this bottle is. If I put this to 0.2, see it look kinda okay. Let me make sure that I have a reassign it to that one. Okay, indeed. So 0.2, a little bit dark. You can increase this up to 1, or maybe I put this to 0. Okay, now let's see the difference between 0.2 and 0.4 and 0.8. See, it's getting a little bit kind of blurrier and blurrier. Okay, if you go to 4, it will be super clear. For this bottle, I would go to 0.8, and then I will change the color to green. In this medium transmitting, just put it to green. See, it changed to green. It's easy. Change this bottle to some kind of like that, which is a real bottle. Polarization, it doesn't do much effect. You need to read a lot more document for that. You see, it blend nicely with the AI standard material with this water. I would go down more to the refraction. For the refraction scale, I will make this a little bit blurry, 0.8. You see, the bottle will change drastically. If you increase this value, your bottle will look just like that. See? No matter how you increase this up to 4, 4 does mean light, super light. So see, the roughness U and roughness V control everything in there. I would make this 0.8. See, and if I put this 0, it looks super clear. But if I make this a little bit, yeah, not too much, not a little bit, let's say 0.3. Okay, the bottle look absolutely blurry. You can also increase the scale, just a test. You see, it looks super bright. Maybe 4 if you want it that way, or maybe like 0.5. wow, it's look like another bottle instead. So you can always test around. 0 super dark, yeah. 0.1, you can play around. 1 is maximum, is like recommended one, or you can go to 0.8. yeah, for a dark bottle I would play with 1. After refraction, direct refraction, it I don't care about that. This one as well, it doesn't do anything good. For the dispersion, that's mean it will produce a kind of like rainbow effects. Without it, doesn't have any rainbow effect. A rainbow effect is kind of, you know, when you look at a particular glass or a diamond or anything, it will produce this kind of rainbow effect. So I don't need it. I turn it off. Spectral conversion, I don't need that. Specular allow you to, you can also mess around with this a little bit. But just like in a refraction, this will increase the specularities of your light of your bottle. You see, it's getting, let me put that to extreme so you can see. As you look, see the edge of that, the edge down here. Okay, if you want, you can go to another extreme. You just let's say 20. See that? Okay, I would go to 10. That's it. Component, nothing. Now we need to go down to other. You need to turn this refract skydome light, otherwise it doesn't render correctly. Also in the shadow and caustic, I would go for the transmission. Already doesn't show any caustic transmission now. You need, I change it to 2. Okay, for the love of God, I would all. And you can also play around with all of this. Dispersion, whatever. Dispersion is meant to produce some kind of a rainbow effect caustic down here. You can turn them all on just to see how things are working. But it doesn't so much. So I would turn them off. Okay. So now let me do the water stuff. I would get another one. I call JF water. Okay, and then I select the inside of that. Apply. See, it's dark. Just like before, if we go up, the basic you can set to medium priority, maybe like 1. But for the liquid, it recommended to go to 2. Okay, and then for the transmission scale, I would go to 4. So we can see things clearly. Some people would like this one would go to 0. So they can see the water. Let me refresh that. Let's change this transmission to this color. Okay, the reason that we did not see that, because I think we need to change this to 1, yeah, and the water to 0. If you change the water to 2, that's another story. A little bit, just, and 0 would be fine. If you want to be clearer, you can go to 6, should be clear. But if you go to 1, it's like a start. 2, you can mess around. 8, see, it will show clearly the inside of that. So I would go to 6. Yeah, maybe 8. That should be good. And then I would turn polarization, refraction, for the waters to be a little bit like murky. I would go to 0.45, and you can increase more so the water will be absolutely like honeybee. Okay, you see, 0, it's different, but it will show you the difference when you render high resolution. Okay, you want, play around, see, maybe 2, okay, cool. And you can see the caustic around here. Go down all the way to the dispersion if you want a rainbow effects. I don't want it too much. For the specular, I would go a little bit. And I would play around with this. So we go 3. Let's try the extreme. 30. Okay, I think go to 5. Or maybe like 10, because we want to see it down here. And in this, turn that on. Okay, but we seem to lose this kind of refraction around here. So I would go to caustic up to 2, and then we have to check the bottle again. Why? it isn't so. Okay, let me try direct spec, direct refract, turn them all on. Mag distance up to 10, the fall off. Okay, let's try transmission other. Now we can see it, this one as well. Transmission outer. Okay, I don't need to turn everything on. I will turn this on off. Now we see it's coming back. Okay, so that looks cool, guy. It depends on which one you like between Arnold shader and also Arnold JF whatever nested material. Let me first do a comparison of side by side. Go to the refraction, increase this a little bit up to 0.4, and then I will delete this light. I will use the original plan here that we set up before. Put it up, hyper shade, give that one this one, and this light in the emission, yeah, point maybe 6.5 camera. I increase this to HD so you guys can see HD 540. The render I would go to like before 4, and this one is 6. Actually the recommended one would be 5 here to smooth everything out. I saved it, and no, I would go for HD, yeah, it's this one. Save the data, I will render it, and see you back soon. I hope the light won't go too much, not this, just in case. Okay, maybe, yeah, just one first, and we render one just in case the light is going higher, then it's difficult for us to check thing around. Okay, that looks good, but I want to move this light a little bit, and so we can see the refraction clearly. Go to camera, push this to 4, maybe 5, this one is 6, okay, this one up to 5, yeah, set it, we render, and I will come back when the render finish. So now the rendering is done. In the render time I did 2 rendering. The first one is this one with a little bit of frosted, some kind of frost and blurry, and this kind of straw stuff of refraction. And the second one I did a clean of everything. I just turned everything back down to just set the 4-1. So guys, depend on you how to tweak and set everything along the way. So this is the Arnold, the false shader, and this is the JF-Nested Dielectric Material. It depends on your preference, which one you prefer the most, and which one you think work fast for you. So this is not a lighting award or anything. I just show you how to render all this kind of caustic and stuff inside this inside Arnold with Maya. So I hope you like it, and don't forget English is not my native language, so I tend to have a lot of problem in my talking. Thank you.